Hey everybody, this is Roy Canaday, and this is Favorite Game Friday, where we have a group of contributors who all submit different videos in the category of the week, and they all have very different opinions on the games, and we talk about those games so you can see a variety of opinions on that topic. This week is all about weeknight games. What is a weeknight game? A weeknight game is a game that after you've had a long day of work, you still can get to the table, maybe after dinner, and still have a lot of fun with, but maybe it's not too brain-burning, so it's just a little bit of a relaxing style game. Anyway, let's check out what all the contributors' clips are.
I'm Libby, this is Julian, and together we are Voxed Meeples. And because weekday gaming really means the two of us in the evenings, I have gone for a lovely two-player game sale, which is so quick to get out of the table and really fun to see if you can do that sort of, it's got a trick-taking element to it, and you're trying to move your little boat along without it getting eaten by a kraken, falling into an island, all of that kind of stuff. And it can be trickier than you think, but there's lots of little scenarios in this box. You can sort of ease yourself into the game, but a really lovely two-player game. And I mean, the box itself looks absolutely gorgeous.
I've also gone for a two-player scenario-based game, but one with a very different theme. I've gone for Sky Team. Obviously, in this game, you are together trying to land a plane, but you're sort of pilots and co-pilots who don't want to talk, which isn't the best plan when you're trying to land a plane. But this fits in. You can play this in 10, 15 minutes. There's a bundle of different kind of scenarios you can play in this. It always goes and feels a bit fresh. And what's good about this kind of weekday game, not only is it quick to set up, quick to play, but each of the scenarios feels different. So you could play it on maybe on a few subsequent days, kind of get through some of the campaign and kind of really get to enjoy what this game has to offer.
Yeah, and both of these games are sort of coffee table friendly, so you don't have to have a lot of space out on sort of a bigger or dining table to be able to play, which is always good for us.
Hello, this is Bill Webb, a.k.a. Billy Indiana. And for a game that we like to play on the weeknights, if it's just my wife and I, we might play a quick round of Kohaku, or if we're in a cooperative mood, maybe Endangered to try to save some animals. But a newer one to our collection that we've been enjoying is Sunrise Lane. It's a Reiner Knizia game that's put out by a Horrible Guild. It feels a little bit like Ticket to Ride with a few new things to think about in terms of puzzly working out how you're building your buildings. And there's just enough player interaction and it plays under an hour. Really easy to teach and quick to learn. So it makes a great weeknight game.
Hey everybody, my pick this week is going to be Dice Fishing Roll and Catch. It's a pretty simple little fast dice rolling game. You can probably play it a couple of times in a night. I know Allplay is going to be releasing this very soon under the name Lure, but personally I prefer the art in this one better.
My pick for this week is Let's Summon Demons, because what you want to do on a weeknight is summon demons.
Yeah, and you know what that game is about, right?
Summoning demons.
Yeah, alright, well hey, happy Friday everybody. Bye. Well,
summon some demons for me.
Hey, folks. It's the Beans and Dice Podcast, a podcast about
how we game.
I'm Carlos.
I'm Rob.
And I'm Wayne. And when it comes to gaming on weeknights, it's usually my wife and my young child, 10-year-old. So can't get into super heavy games, but I also want to make them kind of Euro-ish and slightly educational for my younger kids. So usually on a weeknight, we're playing some of the games from Underdog Games, trekking through history, trekking through worlds, national parks, even Her Story. Games that are fun, have good mechanics, teaching my kid about gaming, but also teaching him a little bit about history and geography. So that's my weeknight gaming, usually with my family.
I also like to learn and game at the same time, and for that reason, in the footsteps of Darwin by Sorry We Are French, one of the funniest board game company names out there. What's great about In the Footsteps of Darwin is 2 to 5 players, and 2 to 5 players in about 30 to 40 minutes. And it does it like that every single time. And it feels good. You're going around the world, picking up different animals in order to publish your thesis on different ideas and gathering points. And that little ship, the wooden meeple ship that moves around the board, looks wonderful. Beautiful production. Top-notch quality. In the Footsteps of Darwin.
And I'm going to go the opposite. I'm going to go a two-player game. My weeknight gaming is usually just grabbing one of my three kids and sitting down for a quick game before we wrap up for either dinner or for bed, depending on what time it is at the night. My favorite game designer, Uwe Rosenberg, designs a nice little game called Patchwork. Two-player game. You can usually get it in 30 minutes or less, just about designing or laying out a quilt. It's a little tile laying, collecting buttons to pay for tiles, and you got kind of a rondel that you're moving around the outside of the board to select different tiles. So lots of neat little mechanics, and then once you know this game, you can get it done probably in 15 or 20 minutes. And so perfect weeknight gaming game for us.
And what we'd like for you to do is on Thursday nights, call into our show, Beans and Dice Podcast on YouTube and on Twitch. 813-618-7099 is the number. And tell us why Rob is wrong.
I'm wrong.
About his weeknight selection. So thanks for listening. Thanks for watching. Have a good night.
Hi. My favorite weeknight game is Sky Team. I love this game because it's a good co-op puzzle without being too brain-burning. But the best part are the dozens of scenarios that offer different ways to play without learning a whole new game. Sometimes I'm just thinking about where the selection and where are we going to end up tonight.
Hi, I'm Barb, Maple PhD, and my current favorite weeknight game is The Loop. This is a cooperative game where you are trying to save the timeline from the evil Dr. Foe. I have a friend who's coming over every week, bringing dinner. We're getting this to the table, trying all of the different scenarios, and usually we're done by about 8 o'clock. So that is my current favorite, The Loop.
So my favorite weeknight game is The Crew. You can play one scenario, you can play many scenarios. It just fits whatever time frame you have based on the night. So there you go. That's The Crew. Favorite weeknight game.
Hello, everyone. Dave here.
And I'm Luke.
We're from the YouTube channel 2D Board Gamers. And this week's topic is a game that you would play on a weekday game night. So a game that you would do after work. So, well, this happens to be a weekday night. And we both got off work. We're getting ready to play Marvel Champions.
I don't think that's what you're talking about, Dave. You're talking about shorter games.
Well, Marvel Champions is what we play on weeknights, but sometimes we play other games. And so, like, one would be like The Crew if we had a little bit more than just the two of us. So that would be my second choice.
For me, I actually, a lot of times when I'm thinking weekday game night, I'm thinking about now playing a game with the kids. And my kids love this game, Dungeon Mayhem. It's a little D&D card game to where basically it's a little free-for-all brawl between different characters that have playing different classes of monsters and classes, like, you know, wizards, rogues. You can be a beholder, all kinds of fun little stuff. But it's a fun little quick game that we sit down, play in a short amount of time, and we generally play two or three of them in a row. But that's probably the one for me. So that's it. Dungeon Mayhem.
Okay. Well, enjoy the rest of your favorite game Friday.
For me, I'm going to have to say Splendor Pokemon. Honestly, any of the Splendors would fit in here, but me and my fiance love Splendor. We've had a ton of fun with Marvel Splendor, but Splendor Pokemon, I just really enjoy the way that game kind of comes together and throwing the Pokeballs to get your Pokemon and things like that. So a very charming, chill weeknight game, Pokemon Splendor.
Hi, Dice Tower. JV here. So my wife and I are both teachers, and we definitely know what a school night game typically feels like, something light and quick. But I have kind of a hot take here for you. My pick for favorite weeknight game is Sleeping Gods. And that might be the last type of game you'd think of to play during the week, but hear me out. Basically, this has worked really well in the past. Once you have it set out and ready to go on the table, it's a game that you can just play for 15 or 20 minutes and then call it good. Come back to it the next night, play a few turns, and then call it good again. So this is a nice quick hitter if you can dedicate the table space to it for a week or two to play during the week and just chip away at it. So my pick for favorite weeknight game is actually Sleeping Gods.
Shuff 10 of the Dice Tower Library is kind of known as our welcoming games, or possibly could be even our weeknight game shelf, but no game has had the success for me as Trio has, or Nana, the Japanese release of it. We've played this with family. We played this until midnight one time, just round after round after round, and then we regretted it the next day. But any game can be a weeknight game if you try hard enough.
Hello, Merlin's Manor here, and my favorite game to play in the middle of the week is Cascadia. It's very quick to set up and to put away, and it can be played in about 30 to 45 minutes and offers a very satisfying puzzle without being too much of a brain burner. So I really enjoy playing this, and it doesn't take too much to get it out and play it. Happy Friday, everyone.
Hey, favorite game Friday. What's a great weeknight game? The cooperative cat game. Yes, you heard me right. Cooperative cat game. Hissy Fit, about taking cats to the vet. This is a really light 20-minute game that works really well when you're like, want to cooperate together, but you don't want to think too much, but it's still a fun little super cute game. So that's Hissy Fit.
It's always awesome to see all the games that people can casually play and relax on a weeknight. I do want to say thank you to Jordan for kind of inspiring this segment as well. And he's just one of our other contributors who talks about weeknight games on our Board Game Breakfast a ton of times. So do make sure to check out Board Game Breakfast as well. But hey, if you have a weeknight game, especially if one wasn't mentioned here below, make sure to put it in the comments and make sure to check out all of our contributors from all around the world who join in. If you want to be one of those contributors who would like to join in for Favorite Game Friday, we would love to have you. And all you have to do is do a super short clip and leave it in the Google Drive link down below. It's super accessible, a super easy way to be a part of Board Game Media and have a video here on the Dice Tower. That would be really cool to have you join in. Next week, we're going to be talking about upcoming games. We have Gen Con coming up. Essen is right around the corner. Are there games that are going to be coming out or have been announced that you're really excited about? Make sure to put an upcoming game that you are super stoked about in a super short video about that in the Google Drive link down below, and we'll see you on the next Favorite Game Friday. Have a good weekend, everybody.
Hey folks, thanks for watching another one of our videos. If you like our videos, if you like our channel, you would love to game with us at one of our conventions. Check out Dice Tower Cruise, Dice Tower East, and Dice Tower West. Fantastic conventions where we play games with wonderful people, a humongous library, and lots of other events and stuff. Also, don't forget to check out our channel, like and subscribe. I'm Tom Bassel.